Thank you so much for a few to inviting me to express a view of one district, one product concept implemented in India. And I'm going to present how this has been implemented in the phased manner at India. Before going to that, why this concept has been evolved and that's been considered by Government of India is, India is now produced most of the agri commodities like world number one and two, most of the commodities. You can see that world number one in the dairy, fruits and vegetable, world number two, food grains now reached almost 280 million tons. So that's what continuously production is increased in India. And Indian food processing sector also growing in the double digit growth rate almost last 5 years. And the total grocery market at India is stands sixth in the world. And 19% of the total workforce is works in the food processing sector. And size of the industry right now, it is the fifth in the scale, like total production and capacity as well as export. And this continuous growth rate, not only from the larger industry, and it comes from the small and medium and micro industries. And 90% of this total food processing sector is lies with that MSME sector. And under this sector, the food processing, 25 lakh of food processing enterprises are unorganized. They are not registered. And they mostly it's a family owned organizations. And the investment on the plant and machinery is very, very low. So as like around 7%. And more than 60% of this micro food processing enterprises are at rural area. And second thing, this is the industry has yield a lot of employment in the rural area, but they are unable to expand their business into the larger extent. What are the issues or challenges they faced by the micro food processing sector is one of the issues, the access to the modern technologies. They may be age old technologies, they are practicing, they are producing the product, they are sending to the supply chain. But they wanted to upscale or they wanted to adapt newer technology, where to go, how to get that technology, how to increase the efficiency or reduce the wastage. That is the big challenge faced by these micro food processing enterprises. Second one is that capital deficiencies as well as the loan credit. They take most of these units that takes the loan and the repayment and all this issue put a lot of pressure on the system, not able to expand their capacity. And lack of awareness and training of mainly for the food safety and control system. They should understand what are the quality parameters has to be maintained, good manufacturing practice, how to implement the HACCP systems and branding and marketing. And this is the one area they satisfied with the market, what they are selling at the local market, maximum district level or the state level. How to penetrate in the whole countries and outside the country. How to market their branding into the international level. This is the one great challenge faced by this micro food processing sector. And how to sort it out, this type of problem faced by the micro food processing enterprises. That's what Government of India launched last year, Prime Minister formalization of micro food processing enterprises scheme. This is the centrally sponsored scheme, budget close to the 10,000 crore for the 2020-24, and selected almost 707 district and with 137 ODOP products. This is a product specific scheme. Each district identified one product. This is identified by the state nodal agencies and state governments. They have the data, how much total production in the particular district and how many existing units, how much raw material available to go for the processing and how much new units can come into that one. Based on that, this 137 ODOPs have been selected. And who are the people are going to get benefited? One is the farmers producers organizations and self-help groups also can be part of this process, and the existing food enterprises as well as the new entrepreneurs both can come into that. Existing entrepreneurs no need to come under the ODOP scheme, but new enterprises, they have to apply under the ODOP. The selected district, suppose they selected one district as the, for example, coconut, they have to apply in the coconut processing units. That's what their whole structure has been made. And the whole objective was the one is the access to the credit. That's what this micro food processing enterprises has been issue on the access to credit. This gives easy to access to the banking sector. Second one is the professional and technical support. So we made all the technical institution in the India based on like a CSIR, ICR, or a Ministry of Food Processing Industry institutions, we made the network. So whatever the technologies available with this institution, these industries, the micro food processing industry can get it. And apart from that, we like to strengthen these institutions. And one more beauty of this ODOP concept is the common facilities. For example, somebody can start the unit with their own money along with the credit support and government support what is given under the PMFME scheme. If they don't have the land or space or even at money, they can bring the raw material, go to the common incubation facilities, they can process, they can pack and take it. So it takes care about the whole spectrum who wanted to do the even business itself. And the what is the target number? This next 4 years time, we are targeting almost 2 lakh micro food processing enterprises bring into the formalized manner. And how the support goes under this scheme is 35% government support, the subsidy will be given to the existing as well as the new enterprises. Existing enterprises wanted to expand or capacity increasing, whatever it is they wanted to put it, 35% support. New enterprises, as I said earlier, it is considered under the one district, one product concept. Apart from that, same 35% government support will be given for the farmers, producers, organizations, health, self-help groups, cooperatives as well. And one more beauty of this scheme has been support for the marketing and branding. They can brand it their product. Suppose particular region or particular district, they wanted to brand that unique brand into the global brand. It's possible to do that, the branding and marketing support also given to do that. That is the what we need to generate more employment. Not only that, other way around, that particular brand is created in the particular locality, more tourist spots and other people can come to that, visit into that place to buy that product. So that is the what that branding and marketing also included under the scheme. And how that capacity building program has been inbuilt under the scheme, because we understand that training program is very much important to implementing such a level of going to village level, taluk level, because we need to empower the people. They have to understand what is the food business and how to do their product and how to market their product. That's what that national institution like Indian Institute of Food Processing Technology, where I am there, and apart from that, our sister institution, NIFTM, join hand to develop the total curriculum of the training program. And each state master trainers will be trained, and this master trainer in turn, they train the district level trainers. This district level trainer will train the district resource persons. This district resource person act between the communicating between the beneficiaries or who are the applicant. So this district resource person develop the DPRs, detailed project report and application process, handhold support, everything will be connect between the government system and the beneficiaries. So whole spectrum has been covered under the capacity building, and these are the component we aim to give the training in our material. One is the raw material availability. That is the key element, including water, how much available, how much they can use, and the pricing. Initially, most of the this type of industry go for the lower pricing, and later if inflation increase, they can't able to increase the price. That how to fix the pricing and consumer preference. This is a key element. Now, earlier, for example, 100 years back, we used to take food for the energy. 50 years back, we have taken food for the nutritious. Now, people want to take food for soul. The people mindset is entirely changing, and the market demand is changing day by day. So such a scenario will be included, and already we included in the some of the curriculums, and also technological upgradation and waste utilization. For example, if you take that rice milling unit, 31% wastage is generated in the rice milling on an average. So how to utilize even that wastage? Any industry, that small industry, what is the waste utilization? How to use that waste utilization? It has been inbuilt on the curriculum of most of that our subject area, what is the master trainers. And one specifically, each and every training has focused on the food packaging. This is not only that food packaging is a simple one, because that is the one attracts the people and the labeling. They have to be aware of that. What are the labeling regulations in India and outside our country? So that clearly spelled out the given the training to the all the beneficiaries, and also supply chain management as well as logistic, including that. So they have to understand how the whole supply chain is takes place, including the storage and the logistic and the final end product where it's reaching, and the documentation of the whole scenario from the raw material procurement to the end product. So these all the things inbuilt on our curriculum, apart from the food safety and the regulations, because regulations in India, FSSAI is regulating the total food safety and all the regulations. For example, someone start the business on even coconut processing, what are the regulations on that oil processing, what are the regulations? So all these things inbuilt on the our curriculum, and this is the resource material we made it available in open source. For example, ODOP wise demonstration videos, detailed project report, everything we already uploaded, like 138 what I said, that all the detailed reports has been uploaded in our website, including like FSSAI regulations, course material. And if you go to the our portal, we can get all this detailed report and the videos. And this is the PMFME capacity building portal of Ministry of Food Processing Industry. If you click here, we will get all this training material. And for example, fruits and vegetable processing, if you go there, we have the detailed videos, all the fruits and vegetable products selected by the ODOP in the particular district has been uploaded here. For example, guava juice, and here PowerPoint presentation as well as the video for how the processing technologies. And India, we have a lot of other local languages. We made it the videos in the different languages as well. If you click that English, so we have the videos, so that will give entrepreneurs confident on making this type of product. So end-to-end solution has been given in the portal itself. For example, here how it goes on the processing, and each stage, the cleaning, washing, processing, and final product is end product, whatever it comes. This all the demonstration, not only that, trainer's guide, suppose master trainer, how to give the training to the district level training, and how to give the training to the resource person. All this component has been inbuilt and it is uploaded in our website. And earlier I said about our incubation center, and this is the what common food processing center has been created. Right now it's a 54 center has been created, and right now we are giving 100% fund to the government institutions and private institution 50% fund, and mentoring institution has to be there in the application itself, because some institutions maybe have the good expertise on particular field. For example, banana, National Resource Center for Banana has the expertise on that, so they have to take such institution as a mentoring institution. And operational and maintenance operation O&M also has to be awarded to the third party. This is the total business model has been created, and based on that this incubation center has been created. It's totally based on ODOP concept. Already we given these are the areas like a minor forest produce. This is like a mostly the tribal products for the mushroom, tamarind, and honey, such type of lines. Even we wanted to emphasize, and we wanted to encourage tribal population can start processing their product in the mainstream level. And then fruits and vegetables, spice, fish, and grain oils, all these lines has been already approved, and still some more processing line we are going to add in every year. And our aim is to end hunger and achieve the food security to world. It's possible to achieve either at one village, one product, or one nation, one product, or one district, one product. We need to emphasize the local employment, because such type of approach definitely enhance the local employment and local business model. So that will enhance the localized food security as well as in the hunger. Thank you so much for inviting.